this cathedral, a short distance from the London Anatomy office, clergy and congregation welcome the friends and families of donors so that together in this service we can celebrate his work in promoting the giving and saving of lives across generations. Our sympathy and condolences to your loved ones who gave their bodies for scientific research. This service of reflection and thanksgiving is for them. They gave themselves so that others might learn, so that more might live. We come here today, May 17th, to celebrate that gift of self, that joy which enables generations of new minds to endeavor through research and teaching to secure the futures of generations yet unborn. As friends and families of those who have donated themselves, we celebrate the work of the London Anatomy Office. May it long continue to echo that great sacrifice of our Lord Jesus Christ. Please.
I have a secret to share with you, and that's that I'm actually very nervous in speaking with you today. It's not that I'm not used to speaking in crowds, it's just that the stakes are extremely high today. And if I had all the time in the world, and if I had a Shakespearean mastery of the English language, I still wouldn't be able to find the words to show the immense gratitude that I want to. So I'm going to speak to you today from my heart and my soul, and I hope that's how it's received. So you'll hear it with your ears, but I hope you feel it, because that's what the intention is. There's just a couple of things that I want to concentrate on, and the first thing is to relay to you, which, and I think this is extremely important, of how not just appreciated your loved ones are, but the care and delicacy of how they are treated and through all the institutions, and that goes from the students, the academic staff, the technical staff. They really are put on quite a high pedestal in our opinions and are treated in that way. The other thing I want to try and get to you is the impact of the sacrifice. And the sacrifice is immense, both on your loved ones' parts and on yours. And we do know that. We appreciate that. That sacrifice informs learning and knowledge. It increases that knowledge tremendously. And this leads to improved treatments, enhanced life quality for people, and the extension of life, in fact, which we all appreciate. What your loved ones give us is a chance to care better for those people during their most vulnerable and desperate times of their lives. And there can be no real higher calling than that. In that, your loved ones have created an eternal legacy for humankind. Now, as I said earlier, I just don't have enough words to express the immense gratitude for what you've done and for what your loved ones have done. And I did want to just leave my talk with some words, but I thought, well, what could I say? and nothing really could be topped by translating this saying, because as the original person that said this held the people he was speaking about in this regard, we hold you and your loved ones in this regard, and you'll recognize it now, modified. So I say, in the field of science and medicine, never has so much been owed by so many to so few. And I thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Good morning. Thousands of doctors graduate from London and the surrounding areas each year. And 8 medical schools benefit from the privilege of an anatomical education that is bestowed upon us by the donors, of which we are here to honour and to give thanks to. In this sea of anonymity, there remains a commonality, this being the shared experience of the living learning from the deceased. And indeed, I will always remember the moment I first stepped into the anatomy classroom and met my teacher, the donor, and the donors which we all gather here to pay tribute to remember and to thank. And whilst they could not talk, their presence was very much felt. Each teacher was and is unique, and the privilege I receive in understanding this uniqueness of human body, mind, and spirit is something I will remain in awe with for the rest of my career, and I hope in my life. We become acquainted with our teachers just as we would and will with our patients over the course of the year. Though those months, precious as they are to us, inevitably come to an end. Yet, the memory, their memory, continues to live on. Leaving that classroom for the last time, I said goodbye to that first teacher, my first teacher, who guided me through the intricacies of the human body. My teacher, the one who taught me respect, kindness, dignity, compassion, consent, non-verbal communication, both in life and in death. Lessons which, 2 years later, I continue to refine in my teacher's memory. And I will always feel honoured and grateful as one of the recipients of the greatest gift your loved ones could have ever given to me or to us, the foundations of a lifelong education. Thank you.
Good morning. I'd firstly like to thank everybody for attending the service today and the organisers for allowing me the opportunity to speak. It's a great honour. My highest gratitude is reserved to the donors themselves, though, and that is, of course, the reason for my speaking today. As medical students, there are a few things we really need to master before our bubbles are burst and we're thrown into the world of being a doctor, with all of the joys and stresses that come with that. And one of those things is a very, very strong fundamental knowledge of anatomy. A doctor who doesn't have this is somewhat like a navigator without a compass. And that is, of course, not safe for patients. The educational impact of body bequeathal in creating safe and knowledgeable doctors is profound. It is second bar none when learning this subject, anatomy. Some people, quite understandably, may wonder why alternative ways of learning anatomy cannot be used instead, maybe textbooks or virtual models. But as doctors, we're going to be treating real patients, not virtual models. So how else can we develop our education but through the study of real anatomy? But perhaps even more importantly than all of this, through learning in this way, we learn to appreciate the individual in front of us and not reduce them down to a vessel, a biological phenomena. We learn to understand that the person in front of us was very real indeed. They had a family to care for, friends to laugh with, responsibilities to bear, dreams to chase, passions to pursue, places to see, stories to pass on, jokes to tell, memories to cherish. And we take with us an understanding of this when we grow up and prepare to move into the world of medicine. We learn that our actions have real consequences, and that what may be to us just a job is a crisis in a person's life. We learn to treat the patients we see and not simply the diseases we encounter. And this indeed is the very essence of medicine. Donors and the wonderful teams who look after them so carefully allow this to happen. Expecting nothing in return, their generosity allows medical students and doctors to become far better and far safer at their jobs. It allows them to become more caring and empathetic people in general. And it allows us to understand far better who we are as a species. Undoubtedly, this will profoundly improve the health of our society in the long run. I cannot think of an act more selfless nor altruistic than body bequeathal, and everybody I have ever been taught by and studied alongside would agree with this sentiment. We must never take for granted their generosity, for what greater gift can there be than the education they have given us? We must never cease to maintain the very high standard in which we treat the deceased, with the utmost respect, dignity, and gratitude. They, among us all, deserve it unreservedly. Thank you very much.
Good morning. My warm greetings to all of you on this special day and on this auspicious occasion when we join hands to commemorate, to celebrate, and above all, to acknowledge with respect and profound gratitude the selfless generosity and altruism of a number of very special individuals whose names appear in the order of service, and many of whose photographs are displayed on these tables in front of you. For my part, I feel immensely honored to have been invited to deliver the address at the service of reflection and thanksgiving in this beautiful cathedral. And I'm most grateful to Dr. David Parry for according me this great privilege on behalf of the London and Southeast Committee of Anatomists. I speak on behalf of all members of the medical profession, and not merely on behalf of the medical schools of London and the Southeast, when I express gratitude and respect to all those individuals whom we remember today. I have dedicated the past 36 or so years of my life to the teaching and training of surgeons, young and not so young, at the Royal College of Surgeons, and to the teaching of medical students in London and elsewhere. Over this long period, I have witnessed many spectacular, even revolutionary developments and advances in surgical treatment. I have also witnessed some impressive technological advances in the methods used in medical education in general and in the teaching of anatomy in particular, both at the undergraduate level and at postgraduate level. But in my view, none of the innovations in teaching methods has surpassed the unique, precious, and incomparable experience of learning and teaching human anatomy and surgical technique that is to be gained by making use of the generosity of those individuals who have bequeathed their bodies to support medical education and surgical training. Their gift is a benefaction like no other. And for the students and trainees receiving that precious gift and benefiting from that gift, that is a special privilege like no other. The Holy Bible reminds us, through the words of Lord Jesus himself, that it is more blessed to give than to receive. Sadly, our societies in the present day are so preoccupied with the acquisition of material possessions and place such a high value on pecuniary wealth that generosity and the act of giving are frequently measured in monetary terms. These days, even the undeniable success of a perfectly commendable and worthy charitable event is likely to be announced and advertised in terms of record sums of money raised and donated. In this context, I am reminded of the words of the late Khalil Gibran, the renowned Lebanese-American poet and author, who in his most well-known work, entitled The Prophet, wrote the following words: "You give but little when you give of your possessions. It is when you give of yourself that you truly give." Those whom we commemorate today did exactly that. They gave of themselves, and in a manner that is essentially without end and is not bound by time, as there is really no finite end point to the knowledge acquired and passed on by the recipients of their gift. Each person whom we commemorate today made a conscious, well thought through, and deliberate decision during his or her life to bequeath something intensely personal and highly precious. What made this act even more remarkable was that these individuals were donating their bodies to complete strangers, regardless of the recipient's social background, religious beliefs, political allegiance, or nationality. What could possibly be more altruistic than that, I ask you? And what of the recipients of these gifts? In the main, young women and men in the prime of their wonderful and exciting lives, and with so much to look forward to. What I would say to them is this: in the frenetic pace of your exciting professional and social lives, studying, practicing, socializing, and enjoying life, please always spare a thought for the generous individuals whom we honor today, and to whom you owe some, at least, of the privileges you enjoy today and will enjoy to an even greater extent in years to come. The best way of repaying the selfless generosity of your benefactors, these remarkable donors, is by making the most of the opportunity they have provided for you. It is really the only way you have of expressing your respect and gratitude to these noble individuals. I would also like to say, on behalf of the London and Southeast Committee of Anatomists, a very big thank you to the family members and relatives of those whom we commemorate today. Many of you are here today to remember and pay your respects to the departed souls, your loved ones. All of you had the strength, the courage, and the determination to honor the wishes of your loved ones at what must undoubtedly have been a time of great personal distress and grief. Yet each of you showed selflessness and generosity in giving up your loved and respected relative in order that he or she could realize their ardent and cherished wish to touch the lives of others when their own lives had run their course. For this, I salute you with admiration, with respect, with gratitude, and with warmth. It now only remains for me to thank Father Joseph Donker for his opening moving words, and for the choir of King's College London for their beautiful choral music, and you, the congregation, for listening. Thank you.
the chaplaincy team at King's College London see ourselves as being here to serve people of all faiths and none. So if you are able or willing to join in with this short time of prayer, then please do. But you're also most welcome to just use it as a short time to commemorate your loved one, a life well lived, in your own private way. So let us pray. It is with great pride that we gather here today to give thanks for your loved ones who gave their very selves so that the next generation of healthcare professionals can make the world a better place. We thank you, family and friends of our donors, for your part in this precious journey. Thank you all for taking on the immense responsibility of honouring the last wishes of your parents, grandparents, brothers, sisters, aunties, and uncles. We thank the staff of the London Anatomy Office for their diligent service in offering advice and pastoral care when families are grieving and at their most vulnerable. We thank you for those professors, demonstrators, technicians, and chaplains whose responsibility it is to introduce our students to their very first patients and to remind them of the respect with which they must approach the learning environment they are about to enter. We pray and give thanks to all those medical professionals who dedicate themselves to alleviating the pain of others. Give them wisdom in their learning, imagination in their research, and compassion in their care for patients. Sustain in them their reverence for life and search for wholeness in healing, that the lives of many may be enriched. And as we honour the lives of those we remember this day, we pray for those who grieve the loss of loved ones. Lord, as the one who heals the brokenhearted, may they know your comfort and grace. As we approach the 300th anniversary of the foundation of Guy's Hospital next door to Guy's Campus and Medical School, we give thanks for the vision of Thomas Guy in founding a place of healing for those deemed to be incurable, those who had no one else to bring them comfort or hope. We pray for our medical school partners throughout London and the South East, whose duty it is to fulfill Guy's motto, Dare Quam Accipere. It is better to give than to receive. May we also take up this mantle, using our gifts and talents for the benefit of all. Uniting our prayers in the words that Jesus taught, I invite you to join in the words of the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Go forth into the world in peace. Be of good courage. Hold fast to that which is good. Render to no one evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Support the weak. Help the afflicted. Honor all people. Love and serve the Lord, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit rests upon you this day and forevermore. Amen.